I chose was basically a dispute between a tile company and a farmer that wants to get new wood tile. He gets brochures and everything from across the border. He lives in Austria. The company is in Germany, which is just across the border from where he lives. It's so close to him that he's able to drive to the place, you know, instead of getting the information over the phone. He doesn't accept the offer on the phone. He wants to be able to meet in person, you know. After they promise him that everything's going to be uniform, he goes to the place, he inspects the tiles, you know. He doesn't accept the offer until he goes back home to his home in Austria. Once he accepts the offer, you know, the people come out, they do their job. It's not until after the jobs are together to see that is not how it's supposed to be. So, once he notices that it's not how he wants it to be, then he, the law enforcement involved, as anyone would do, if I paid a bunch of money for my tiles to be fixed on my roof, I would be upset if they weren't the ones that you promised me to come in, the ones that I paid for, you know, the ones that I picked out and told you in your face that I wanted. That he ends up pressing charges in the Austrian court, because you know that's where he lives, and considering that Bewa was in Germany, he still received brochures across the border, so they still had advertisement across the border, so the opportunity to deal would matter which court he went to. So him living in Austria, he chose the Austrian court. So after he, you know, presses charges and everything, and then Bewa, you know, gets the notice of it or whatever, they reject it, saying, you know, that's not what happened. We're gonna fix what happened. And when Mr. Gruber presses these charges, he's using the Article 13 of the Brussels Convention, you know, to found jurisdiction. He does this because he knows he is in Austria, and Bewa is living in Germany. He presses charges on the fact that the tiles weren't right, and they promised him they would be. You know, they gave him a warranty about it, and they promised it would be uniform. Once the judge looks over the contracts, he's got to determine if it's a mixed contract or if it's a consumer contract. And once the judge does that, that will determine what happens next. Unfortunately for Mr. Gruber, the judge did not feel that it was a consumer contract. Therefore, the Article 13 didn't apply. Therefore, jurisdiction was denied. I don't feel that that was right for Mr. Gruber, because if I was a business owner for Bewa, I, as a company leader, would have said, we messed up, we screwed up, we promised you something that we didn't give you, let us fix it, we'll pay in order for you to want to come back to us. Because he's going to go tell his friends, his other farming buddies down the road, they're going to need new tiles one day on their silo, and maybe they want to use Bewa. Well, they're not going to now because Bewa screwed Mr. Gruber over. And what are they going to do now? So, ultimately, I feel that they could have fixed it for him, they could have, you know, done what they could have rather than just tell him, you spent the money, you're not getting a bag, and we're not going to get your towels. So, he lost money, and he's got crappy towels now. The first question is, why do you believe the judge didn't think they entered into a consumer contract? I don't believe that they entered into a consumer contract because the company sent it to his bank and not to the consumer himself. The second question is, do you believe this is fair to Mr. Gruber, to Bewa? Why or why not? Like I said before, I don't believe Mr. Gruber was given what he was supposed to. I don't believe it was fair to Mr. Gruber. And I believe Bewa got what they wanted, because as far as I'm understanding, they didn't give him any money. They didn't give him any, you know, new tiles to fix it. They didn't redo what was messed up. So Mr. Gruber still has his tiles that he doesn't. Still has his money. So Mr. Gruber didn't win. The warranty didn't say if we screw up we'll fix it. It said they promised they would be uniform. And they weren't uniform, so they screwed up, they should fix it.